Hello and welcome to today's video that is brought to you by my Patreons. If you also appreciate the videos that I make, I would like to see more of them and support my channel, don't hesitate to visit my Patreon page, the link is in the description. In today's video I'm going to work on this cello, which has a pretty big crack here. It's a kind of damage that happens pretty easily on cellos as they have very large ribs, especially at the underside, which is the side which is under the instrument, so it's very easy to bump it somewhere. I don't know how exactly this client did this. I don't see a sign of a bump on the ribs. Anyway, the crack is so big that I can even see through the crack and through the F-hole until my table. That's impressive. Fortunately, it is broken in a way that is pretty easy to repair. Last week I also did this kind of repair on another cello, but I didn't have so much time to film it, but I have a couple of pictures. I will start by gluing the crack, and I will use white glue as I want this crack not to open anymore, and white glue dries slower than the hot glue and will give me some more time to manage to close the gap neatly. I will use my regular glue clamps. This will be enough. That's some extra. I won't put too much pressure at the beginning because it is not completely level. Now I can slowly, slowly make the two sides of the crack level and then I will clamp it with full pressure. And that's why I used also white glue, because I know that I have more time to correct everything. Okay, this looks good. As always, it has to dry, so I will see you in a little while. The glue is dry, so I can remove the clamps. Okay. Now, I want to reinforce the crack, which is here. And to do that, I'm going to open the top from one block to the other. And then with clamps, I will put small pieces of wood inside. I think 5. Let's open the top. And of course, I will use my butter knife. It's already very famous, this knife. A lot of people talk about it in the comments. Okay, something like that must be enough. Now I can open a little bit. It's not so much, but I think that it is enough because I have clamps that are not very thick. So my idea is to put it inside like that and then turn it and clamp it. I will prepare some pieces of wood for this. I prepared 6 small pieces of wood. It is a triplex of 1 millimeter thick. I'm going to use these ones for a couple of reasons. First of all, it is very strong and very light. Second, it bends a little bit, and that means that it will follow the curve of the inner part of the ribs. as I don't have the possibility to make pieces of wood that fit exactly the curve of the inner part of the ribs, I will use these ones which will bend a little bit and follow the curve as I want to. I have also glued already one on my clamp. I will use white glue because I want to be sure that they will never come off. The problem is also that I cannot see the crack at the inner side because it is very neat. So I have put a piece of tape, as you see, on the instrument, and I marked where I want the patches to go. I also made them round because in this way I won't have to take care about the orientation. I have only one clamp that is long enough, so I will have to do it in 6 separate times. First time is done, waiting a couple of hours, and then I will do the next one. All the reinforcements are on their place. Finally, I glued 5 and not 6 because I forgot that the block goes until almost there where I wanted to put the last one, so I didn't need to put it. Now I can glue the top again onto the ribs. It's glued, now it has to dry. The glue is dry, now I can remove all the clamps and mount the instrument. The cello is in one playing piece again, I still have to tune it. But the most important is the crack, which is almost invisible. I think that the client can be very happy. That's it for today's video. Thank you very much for watching. Many thanks also to the Patreons for supporting my channel. Don't forget to visit my Patreon page if you also would like to become a supporter. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and use the bell icon to get notifications whenever I post a new video, that is twice a month. Like the video and I will see you next time again. Bye bye!